Yeah, and the students, I'm Kanchan here, and I'm just taking this chapter 5, What Books and Burials Tell Us. So in this chapter, you will read about Vedas and about its importance and about the burials. Burials means the burial ceremony of dead bodies, means Hindi mein dafnana bolte hain. As the bell rang, the teacher asked the students to follow him because they were going to the library for the first time. When Mary stepped inside, she found that the library was much larger than their classroom, and there were so many shelves and all full of books. In other corner was a cupboard filled with large old volumes. Seeing her trying to open the cupboard, the teacher said that cupboard has very special books on different religions. Did you know we have a set of Vedas? Then she was thinking, what are the Vedas? So here we have four Vedas in our Hindu religion: the Rig Veda, Sama Veda, Yajur Veda, and Athar Veda. The oldest Veda is Rig Veda, that was composed by before 3,500 years ago. The Rig Veda includes more than 1,000 hymns, means lyrics or shlokas that you can sing also. Suktas, those were suktas or well said. Means they were about the well said, the things that should be done. And these hymns are in praise of various gods and goddesses. So those well said were about the praise of gods and goddesses. These gods are especially Agni, the god of fire, Indra, a warrior god, and Soma, a plant from which a special drink was prepared. And these hymns were composed by Sikhs. Sikhs means Rishi, priest. Taught students to recite and memorize each syllable, and they did it word and sentence bit by bit and with great care. Most of the hymns were composed, taught and learnt by men. A few were composed, so they would recite and they would learn it, and they would enjoy it learning. Now Rig Veda is an old or Vedic Sanskrit, which is different from the Sanskrit language that you use today. So here different type of languages are here. Sanskrit is a part of family of languages known as Indo-European. Like some Indian languages such as Assamese, Gujarati, Hindi, Kashmiri and Sindhi. Asian languages such as Persian and many European languages like English, French, German, Greek, Italian and Spanish belong to this family. And they are called a family because they originally had words in common. As here in English, take the words like matra in Sanskrit for mother, and ma is also for mother. So, and in English, we read and we write mother for ma. Other languages used in the subcontinent belong to different families. For instance, those used in the northeast belong to the Tibeto-Burman family. Tamil, Telugu, Kannada and Malayalam belong to the Dravidian family, and the languages spoken in Jharkhand and parts of Central India belong to Austroasiatic family. So this is the division of the parts where these languages are spoken. Now books we use are written and printed. The Rig Veda was recited and heard rather than read. Means people would recite, people would learn it. So it was written down several centuries after it was first composed and printed less than 200 years ago. So how historians study the Rig Veda? Historians like archaeologists find out about the past. But in addition to material remains, they examine written resources as well. So let's see how they study the Rig Veda. Some of the hymns in the Rig Veda are in the form of dialogues. So this is part of one such hymn, a dialogue between a sage named Vishwamitra and two rivers, Bees and Satluj, that were worshipped as goddesses. So here this is about the dialogues Vishwamitra and between those rivers, and it is here language that we can't read because this language is something very different language. A page from manuscript of the Rig Veda, the manuscript of the Rig Veda on birch bark was found in Kashmir about 150 years ago. It was used to prepare one of the earliest printed texts of the Rig Veda. So it is the language of Rig Veda, right? Okay, students, I will start in my next video. ओके एंड जय हिंद।